program formally starts, just while everyone's still settling in, we're going to sing for you guys a quick nasheed.
Hope you enjoy it.
Forgiveness is a part of iman. No man should ever do harm. A Muslim should always do good. Forgive those he never thought he would.
Forgive and forget, that's how you let all your problems go. Oh, forgive and forget, never hold back until you make it right. Yeah, forgive and forget, and that's how you get the past to stay in the past. Forgive and forget, and that's how you let all your problems go. Oh,
forgive a man for his sins, it's only we all do wrong every day. Forgive a man for his ways.
Forgive and forget, that's how you let all your problems go. Oh, forgive and forget, never hold back until you make it right. Yeah, forgive and forget, and that's how you get the past to stay in the past. Forgive and forget, and that's how you let all your problems go.
Rabbi inni zalamtu nafsi faghfir li innahu la yaghfiru dhunuba illa anta faghfir. Oh Lord, I have wronged myself, so forgive me, verily save you. There is no one who can protect me from the consequences of sinning.
Forgive and forget, that's how you let all your problems go. Oh, forgive and forget, never hold back until you make it right. Yeah, forgive and forget, and that's how you get the past to stay in the past. Forgive and forget, and that's how you let all your problems go. Oh,
Allah always forgives us. He is Al-Ghafar, the most merciful to all. Al-Khaliq, the creator of man.
Forgive and forget, that's how you let all your problems go. Oh, forgive and forget, never hold back until you make it right. Yeah, forgive and forget, and that's how you get the past to stay in the past. Forgive and forget, and that's how you let all your problems go. Oh, forgive and forget, that's how you let all your problems go. Oh, forgive and forget, never hold back until you make it right. Yeah, forgive and forget, and that's how you get the past to stay in the past. Forgive and forget, and that's how you let all your problems go.
Jazakallah.
Jazakallah, and thank you everyone.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Hassan. I'm from Soweto Mdeni. I'm part of a group actually called Ubuntu Islam. They're not here now. They're running a bit late, so they Zain because said I should do something with this drama. I hope you enjoy. The song is called Ngiyamthanda Umam. It's about parents, the importance of parents, the importance of appreciating your parents when they're still alive. Ngiyamthanda mama wami, baba wami. Ngiyababonga abazali bami. Ngiyamthanda mama wami, baba wami. Yes, I thank Allah for them. They say Jannah is under your mother's feet, and your father the key to Jannah. Never disrespect them and always love them. Pay attention to your parents when they teach. Use words of kindness to them every time you speak. They're so amazing, they're so adorable. How I wish I could turn back time and tell them that I love you. Yeah, ngiyamthanda mama wami, baba wami. Yes, I thank Allah for them. Ngiyamthanda mama wami, baba wami. Ngiyababonga abazali bami. Ngiyamthanda mama wami, baba wami. Yes, I thank God for them. Ngiyamthanda mama wami, baba wami. Yes, I thank Allah for them. Ngiyamthanda mama wami, baba wami. Yes, I thank Allah for them. There for me when I couldn't seem to reach. Help me come beyond that peak. They're so adorable, they're so amazing. Ngiyamthanda mama wami, baba wami. Ngiyababonga abazali bami. Ngiyamthanda mama wami, baba wami. Yes, I thank Allah for them. Ngiyamthanda mama wami, baba wami. Yes, I thank Allah for them.
Jazakallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My brothers, Ubuntu Islam aren't here yet, so we'll sing a song, inshallah, just the two of us, and then later, inshallah, if they come. This song is just a reminder, no matter what we go through in life, that Allah is always there, God is always there, we should just turn to Him. Bismillah. Bismillah. When you feel all alone in this world, and there's nobody to count your tears, just remember no matter where you are, Allah knows. Allah knows. When you're carrying a monster load, and you wonder how far you can go, with every step on that road that you take, Allah knows. Allah knows. No matter what inside or out, there's one thing of which there's no doubt. Allah knows. Allah knows. And whatever lies in the heavens and the earth, every star in this whole universe, Allah knows. Allah knows. When you find that special someone, see your whole life is barely begun. You can walk on the moon, shout it to everyone. Allah knows. Allah knows. When you gaze with love in your eyes, catch a glimpse of paradise, and you see your child take the first breath of life, Allah knows.
Alanos. No matter what inside or out, there's one thing of which there's no doubt. Alanos, Alanos. And whatever lies in the heavens and the earth, every star in this whole universe, Allah knows. Allah knows. When you lose someone close to your heart, see your whole world fall apart, and you try to go on, but it seems so hard. Allah knows. Allah knows. You see, we all have a path to choose. Through the valleys and hills we go, where the ups and the downs never fret, never frown. Allah knows, Allah knows. No matter what, inside or out, there's one thing of which there's no doubt. Allah knows, Allah knows. And whatever lies in the heavens and the earth, every star in this whole universe, Allah knows, Allah knows. Cause no matter what inside or out, there's one thing of which there's no doubt. Allah knows, Allah knows. And whatever in the heavens and the earth, every star in this whole universe, Allah knows, Allah knows. Every grain of sand in every desert land, He knows. Every shade of palm, every closed hand, He knows. Every sparkling tear on every eye, flash, He knows. Every thought I have and every word I share, He knows. Allah knows.
Thank you so much. Jazakallah khair.
MashaAllah, Zain, who's continued to enthral us for, I think, for years and years, isn't it? Before we get moving, so the Deputy Head of State Protocol, Idris Ibrahim, where are you? Because as per protocol, you've been summoned to come right in front here, just where Yusuf Elim is sitting. Idris, if you can come up here, please. Not sure where he is. We're going to get moving, okay. So here's the plan. So much has happened in the last few months with Yusuf Abramjee in particular, which will unfold over the next hour and a half. And that is why you are all here, to bear witness to all of that. As for me, this is interesting. On a cold winter's night in July, I spent, Yusuf, you better hear this, eh? I spent the night under the stars. I was not alone. I had many friends with me. They included the mayor of Johannesburg, then mayor of Johannesburg, Park Stau, the MEC for transport, Ismail Vadi, who's here with us tonight, the Premier of Gauteng, David Makura, Leanne Menes from Morning Live, Carolyn Stein from 67 Blankets for Mandela, the renowned singer Yvonne Chaka Chaka, star editor Kevin Ritchie. All of them were with me on a night under the stars, because it was the CEO sleepout, remember that? We were ambassadors of the CEO sleepout, but also amongst that group of people, the ambassador of ambassadors was Yusuf Abramjee. And in that busy night, he said something to me. He said, you know, Ashraf, this sleeping under the stars, it really helps you empathize with the poor and the homeless and the poverty stricken. And I said, yeah, I know. But he also said, you know what, Ashraf, it's also really spiritual. And I said, what do you mean? He said, I feel closer to God. I feel closer to my Allah. Because there is no roof. I'm under the stars. There is no roof separating me from the heavens on this night on the Mandela Bridge. And then Yusuf said, you know, Ashraf, I like this. I like the fact that I feel closer to God, closer to Allah on this night under the stars. And he said, I want more of this. And so it was planned and so it was decreed from that night under the stars on the Nelson Mandela Bridge where Yusuf felt closer to his Allah, to our Allah, that he then, it was destined, that he then performs the Hajj, the pilgrimage to Mecca. And you know what? Because he enjoyed the night under the stars so much the first time round, he had another night under the stars on that Hajj when he was in Muzdalifah. And he also had that moment to feel very, very close to his God, to his Allah, to our Allah. And then he felt even closer to Allah, or Allah was even closer to him, as we know, that night than Yusuf's very own jugular vein. And that's why we're here. My name's Ashraf Garda. I'm a friend of Yusuf, but that's being ridiculous because Yusuf, I think everybody is your friend. Anybody wants to argue with that? I think this whole auditorium is your friend. So that's no claim to fame, okay? But it is indeed my great privilege and an absolute honor to be the MC, to be the program director at this, the coffee table launch of this book on Hajj, hashtag 2016, hashtag Abramjee on Hajj. So before we move on with the formalities, quick show of hands here. Who had nothing to do this today and they were just bored and they just pitched up here because they had nothing to do? Pick up your hands. I mean, we're being very open. It's like a DRC here, you know. Okay. No one. So who had other plans and they were willing to cancel when they were told, you better get to the Abramjee book launch? Who had other plans? A couple of people there. Zaid, I can see. Zaid was probably selling ice creams. Well, there we are. A few other people had other plans, right? There we are. Okay. And then, who, when they were told there's the Abramjee book launch this afternoon, said, plans, no plans, it doesn't matter what. I will be here. Who like me did just that? Raise your hands. It's not everybody. Everybody's not convinced. I want to just double check that. Yeah. I'm expecting everybody to do that. Well, I have no doubt that for the vast majority of us, that this is where we want to be. So am I right? Let's confirm this. Is this place right now, it's just past 4 o'clock on a Sunday afternoon, you have many choices. Is this place where you are right now exactly where you want to be, or you want to be elsewhere? Is this where you want to be? Say yeah. Well, that's what I expected. Okay, so there you are, Yusuf. It's all because of you, all right? In terms of cell phones, who's got a cell phone here? Pick up your hands. Cell phone, smartphone, everybody's got it. Okay, so you know when there's good news, what do? When there's good news? You share, you tell people, right? Okay, so here's the responsibility you have. Because if you said no to the cell phone, I understand. Okay, you have a responsibility. Share the good news. Tell someone you are here. Tell them now. Take pictures now. Tell them you are here. Use hashtag Abramjee on Hajj. Can I rely on you to do that? All right. So tweet the pictures or Facebook the pictures or Instagram it. Hashtag Abramjee on Hajj. And give a narrative of why you're here so other people know why you are here. And it's interesting. Do you know what's the top trending story today in the country? Hashtag Jackson Mtembu. And the other one is hashtag Cabo Yellow, referring to Mamelodi Sundowns are playing tonight against Zamalek in the final of the African Champions League. Can I suggest that we attempt to ensure, Yusuf, with your tweeting help as well, I'm looking at the big hitters here. Yusuf Abramjee is here, Aki Anastasio is here, Catherine Constantinides, Yassin's over there. Who else am I missing out on? Minister Derek Hanekom as well. I'm relying on you guys, Ismail MC Body, to change the narrative for the evening so that we get hashtag Abramjee on Hajj to be the top trending story, at least for the latter part of the afternoon. Khadija Patel as well is also here, and I'm sure she will do that as well. Can I rely on you to do that? Okay, fine. The other thing I want to tell you that if you go to YouTube, that this event is being covered live on YouTube. Is it the Souk? Just let me get that right. Souk Islam. So S-O-U-K, go to Souk Islam or tell your friends about it. Tell your friends, you know, share the good news. Tell them Souk Islam on YouTube, on Facebook as well, I think, with Facebook Live and Yusuf Abramjee's page. Yusuf, yeah? On Facebook, if you go Facebook Live, you will see the entire event being covered live as it is. Okay, that's it for me for now. I will say, however, that it is this great privilege to greet you with that universal message of peace. And that is, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon every one of you. Those of you in front, those at the back, those in the middle, those of you who are undecided whether they should come or not, every one of you, may Allah's mercy be upon every one of you. But that's it. The official welcome, however, will now be done. And it's not with me. If I had to introduce you a few years ago, I would have said, the official welcome will be done by a blogger. A few years later, I would have said a journalist or a budding journalist. Then I would have said, well, somebody from Daily Maverick, a very good journalist from Daily Maverick. Just recently, I would have said the boss of the Daily Vox. I would have probably thrown in, she's Yusuf Abramjee's niece. Now I will say, the preeminent editor of the Mail and Guardian will give you the official welcome. So give her the applause and acknowledgement she deserves, Khadija Patel.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My real claim to fame really is that I'm Yusuf's niece. But I'm here today to welcome all of you, absolutely all of you here today. We're here to reflect really on this journey of Hajj and what it meant to my uncle, but also what it means to so many of us. So many of us who yearn to be there. So many of us who are curious about the journey that is undertaken by millions of Muslims every year. And I hope that, you know, this afternoon we use that as, you know, as a moment to reflect. In the grander scheme of things, Yusuf's journey on Hajj this year was quite unremarkable. He got onto a plane, he stayed in a couple of hotels, and he performed his Hajj. You know, in the grander scheme of things, that's quite a regular Hajj. Around the world, however, there are millions of people who have been saving up for years and years and years. People who arrive on Hajj severely disabled, others who walk there from as far afield as China, others who cycle there, others who arrive there by ship. Indeed, our own ancestors have colorful stories of how they embarked on the journey of Hajj, you know, on a ship, and how it took months and months to get there. And it really is a marvel of the way the world has changed, that now this momentous journey is almost so ordinary. And that is really something for us to reflect on as we reflect on Yusuf's journey, but also, again, on what it means for all of us to yearn for this journey, to try to understand why millions of people undertake this journey every year. That said, I'm here to welcome all of you, and in particular, Minister of Tourism, Dari Kanokom, Minister, a very warm welcome to you on behalf of Yusuf and the rest of the family. There are a number of diplomats here as well. Mohammed Abbas Khan, who is South Africa's acting ambassador to Saudi Arabia, and also South Africa's consul general to Saudi Arabia, Shaib Kasu. Diplomats, we welcome you. There are also a number of good family friends here, and as Ashraf said, I think that would mean nearly all of you. But in particular, a good, very good family friend is Gauteng MEC for Roads and Transport, Mr. Ismail Wadi, welcome. And then, of course, the many, many religious leaders and ulama who join us here today, Sheikh Dawood Sampson, who traveled from Cape Town, Mulana Musa Akudi, Kari Ziyad Patel, Mulana Israel Chunara, and many others. From the business industry, there's Mr. Iyad Al-Garawi, who is the GM of the Saudi Arabia Basic Industries Corporation. Welcome to you. And then from the media fraternity, the editor of The Star, Mr. Kevin Ritchie, welcome to you. I swear I'm not sucking up by this next bit. This is from my script. My new boss, Hussein Kajakar, who is the CEO of the Mail and Guardian, was meant to be here, but he unfortunately couldn't make it due to a cycling accident, and he sends his apologies. And then also a warm welcome to Aki Anastasiou, who I don't think needs any further introduction, and also many, many other colleagues from the media who are gathered here today. Also from business, the CEO of FNB Islamic Banking, Aman Mohammed. Aman, welcome to you. And also from FNB, the head of innovation, Stacey Lee Bolon. We've also got the Secretary General of the South African Hajj and Umrah Council, Hassan Chunara, and other officials from SAHUK. And then Janine Hills, who is a board member of Brand SA, among many other titles to her. Welcome. And then, of course, Zain Bika, who sang so beautifully already. We've also got the poet Mzuaki Mbuli, Mr. Andy Mashayile, Catherine Constantinides, and of course, I think a special welcome must also be extended to Yasin Teba, who is the publisher of the book, but has really, I think his whole life was turned around during the course of this. So a special welcome to Yasin and his family, but also to everybody else who was involved in the production, the publishing of this book. And then finally, a welcome to our family. This morning was on the radio with Ashraf, and he asked me to whom or how do I credit my success, and I, and it was a bit of a difficult question to answer, but I think that key to anybody's success and key to any of us doing anything is a supportive family, and I think that our family in particular is always supportive of us, and on behalf of Yusuf, I extend a warm welcome to our family, particularly to my Uncle Yusuf's mum and dad, who are here today, and really to everybody who has assisted in making this afternoon, and indeed this book, a reality. Thank you, and welcome to all of you who are joining us here today. I hope you've all already purchased a book. All right, thank you very much. That's all for me.
Khadija, I hope you're fine. You've got a new job. They say break a leg. You know I'm going to say that, right? There we are. So you could say as well, please buy the Mail and Guardian every Friday from next month. In fact, from November, right? Okay, let's move on then. And I now call upon, because it's very traditional for those of you who are not of the Islamic faith, that we honor occasions by reciting from the glorious Holy Quran, the very word of Allah. And we do that in the Arabic tongue, because that's the tongue that is a universal tongue. The fact that it's in the Arabic language is coincidental insofar as we may not speak it as our first language, but it is for us the language of the Quran, and we believe the language of heaven as well. So I therefore call upon Qari Ziad Patel, who has a wonderfully melodious voice, to recite from the Holy Quran.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وأتموا الحج والعمرة لله فإن أحصرتم فما استيسر من الهدي ولا تحلقوا رؤوسكم حتى يبلغ الهدي محله فمن كان منكم مريضا أو به أذى من رأسه ففدية من صيام أو صدقة أو نسك فإذا أمنتم فمن تمتع بالعمرة إلى الحج فما استيسر من الهدي فمن لم يجد فصيام ثلاثة أيام في الحج وسبعة إذا رجعتم تلك عشرة كاملة ذلك لمن لم يكن أهله حاضر المسجد الحرام واتقوا الله واعلموا أن الله شديد العقاب الحج أشهر معلومات فمن فرض فيهن الحج فلا رفث ولا فسوق ولا جدال في الحج وما تفعلوا من خير يعلمه الله وتزودوا فإن خير الزاد التقوى واتقون يا أولي الألباب ليس عليكم جناح أن تبتغوا فضلا من ربكم فإذا أفضتم من عرفات فاذكروا الله عند المشعر الحرام واذكروه كما هداكم وإن كنتم من قبله لمن الضالين ثم أفيضوا من حيث أفاض الناس واستغفروا الله إن الله غفور رحيم فإذا قضيتم مناسككم فاذكروا الله كذكركم آباءكم أو أشد ذكرا فمن الناس من يقول ربنا آتنا في الدنيا وما له في الآخرة من خلاق ومنهم من يقول ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار صدق الله العظيم.
Karizia, if you can just come back onto the stage. MashaAllah, Qari Ziyad, for those wonderful words from the Holy Quran. And I will state the obvious. Sometimes we wonder, what is the Hajj all about? And you've hopefully followed the translation in English for those of you who didn't understand the Arabic. So much, or 90% of the Hajj, is following the tradition of the family of Ibrahim or Abraham, alayhi salam. From the house that was built, is attributed to his family. To the magic wells of Zamzam, attributed to his family. To the sacrifice of his son, or the attempted sacrifice which they succeeded on, is attributed to his family. And so on and so on. So much. So in fact, the Hajj, followed by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is in fact him emulating a wonderful tradition set up by the Prophet Abraham, the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. Now, for all of us who've been for Hajj, when we think about a national anthem of a country, certain thoughts come to mind immediately. When you think about a national anthem for Hajj, it is the Labbaik, isn't it? It is that call, Labbaik, Allahumma Labbaik. So to get you into that mood of the national anthem of the Hajj, here's the team from the Houghton Muslim School performing the Labbaik.
3, 2, 1, begin.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum, my name is Amani Teba. There are 5 pillars in Islam: Iman, Salah, Zakat, Fasting, and Hajj. Allah, Allah, here I come on my journey to Hajj. Allah, Allah, accept my Hajj. You are truly the best of all the judge.
1, 2, 3, labaik.
Labaik Allahumma labaik, labaik Allah, sharika laka labaik. Inna alhamda wa ni'mata laka wal mul la sharika la. Labaik Allahumma labaik, labaik Allah, sharika laka labaik. Inna alhamda wa ni'mata laka wal mul la sharika la. I am here, oh Allah, I am here. You have no partner. All praise and blessing.
Of Islam. It is compulsory upon every Muslim grown-up who has the means once in a lifetime to go for Hajj. Hajj is a pilgrimage from home to the house of Allah. In remembrance of the sacrifice of Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was a great and noble prophet, Khalilullah, friend of Allah. Jazakallah.
Labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik Allah, sharika laka labbaik. Innal hamda wan ni'mata laka wal mul la sharika la. Jazakallahu khairan, may Allah reward you well.
You want him to stay? Yeah. That was wonderful, don't you think? MashaAllah, it's really, really inspiring. Alhamdulillah. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm sure we all did. And maybe remember now that the national anthem of the Hajji is Labbaik. Let's move on then. So Yusuf told me that the next speaker is an imam, spiritual, as one would expect. But he's also a funny guy. He's got a natural charm and a natural wit about him. Well, he's from Cape Town. I'm talking about Sheikh Dawood Samson. Is the imam of the Parkwood Masjid, but many people have seen him on ITV as well. And Sheikh, as you know, ons is no family. Ons het net nou uitgevind van my vrou se kant, ons is no family. So there we are. There is some family connection, but as we know, we all are in fact family of a greater universal race called the human race. So please give him your fullest attention. Thank you.
Can we all just stand up just for 1 minute, inshallah?
just jive, lift up your hands, breathe in, breathe out, terima kasih. Bismillah, salatu wa salam ala rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, amma ba'd, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Good afternoon to each and everyone here. You know, when I came down here to Joburg now for this weekend, this side here, unlike Cape Town, you know, but so Mr. Abramjee made me relaxed and he put me there into a 5-star, you know, security tight, etc. But Alhamdulillah, yeah, the golf course here, seeing green, Mother Earth, we're feeling much more relaxed. How nice so far, inspiring to meet all my good brass here, mashallah, the likes of great personalities. And this is only an occasion where, again, it's about meeting and greeting. And this is exactly what this book entails, the journey of Hajj. But before I latch on to that, I must admit, in my congregation, I have 5 Yusufs. And throughout the years, we were very, very close. And 3 of them has passed on. And whenever I mention the Jumu'ah, if I make a dua after the congregation for those Yusufs, then I said, if anyone has got a baby on the way, name it Yusuf. And it was a Yusuf Abramjee, mashallah. Like the Yusufs, they always make something happen. So may Allah Ta'ala fill his life also with khair and barakah, inshallah. It's about an intention and then making it move. And what an interesting book. Going through it from cover to cover, it touches hearts because it's Labaik itself, whether you're from Africa, si si se ko lele Africa. But when you clad yourself in the ihram, in that cloth, that white cloth, and you come on the plains there of Makkah, you utter one word, no matter what language you come from, what country you come from, or nationality, Labbaik, Allahumma Labbaik. That Almighty, here I am. This heart has been longing for this journey. Every day I've been in prayers 5 times a day. And here I'm standing now in front of the house of the Almighty, that symbolic house of the Almighty. Almighty, it's only you that I long for. Almighty, wash away all my sins. And it's a link to each and every prophet from Adam, right through Noah, Abraham, Joshua, Joseph, Jesus, each and every prophet till the seal of all prophets, Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon each of them. Like on a yearly occasion, we find the animal kingdom migrates, the dolphins migrates, the whales, the wild beasts, the birds, etc. The cosmos itself is all the time in movement. Once in a lifetime, those that submit only to the Almighty, on the invitation, on the call of Abraham, you are journeying on that spiritual journey. A journey of a lifetime, a journey of hearts, where the Hajj itself, it touches, it moves hearts. And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a righteous Hajj, the reward itself, it's only paradise. One longs for that journey. May Allah Ta'ala make it easy for each and everyone. But the Prophet, when he was asked, what is the inner essence of a righteous Hajj? He said, your speech ought to be that beautiful speech. Your character need to be shining. You need to have a heart of gold, of spreading love, of spreading greetings, and of sharing and caring. And on this journey, we can see in this book of Honorable Brother Yusuf, where he identified the need of giving, and the Hajjis themselves assisted. And this is what makes the Hajj. The more you give, the more you get back. And for our brothers seated here, and for our sisters seated here, Make that intention as an ithali thawab, as rewards that will be continuous in the legacy of our family and our communities, etc. To purchase these books, let it be in libraries, let it be given as gifts around, why? As a reward, an ongoing reward, inshallah, that the rest of people can benefit. How beautiful the saying goes, as our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, that wallahu fi auni al-abd ma dama al-abdu fi auni akhi. When we assist each other, empowering other in goodness, then Allahu Azza wa Jal, the Creator, assists us in goodness. I end off with a beautiful quote, a beautiful line of a number. Reach out and touch somebody's hands. Make this a better place. If we can, yes, we all can. Give me a hand. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
MashaAllah, Sheikh Dawood Samson. Everybody's made a niyyah to say, we also want to go for Hajj soon, Imam Samson, but we want to go with you. All right, Yusuf, you pass the message on. Imam, we need to go with you now. Reach out and touch. The message is very, very clear. We alluded to Mecca and the valleys of Mecca just now, or Mecca, right, in the Arabic language. And Zain Beeker has performed, as a performing artist, he's done so many things. The one song that has always inspired me, and I'm sure will inspire you, and I think is the most appropriate of all the songs that he should perform today, is simply called Mountains of Mecca. Zain?
JazakAllah khair. Thank you, Yusuf, for inviting us, and Yasin. Also want to make a special shout-out to my teacher, Maulana Chunara, my friend also, my good friend, Mzwakim Buli. He's a great inspiration to all South Africans, alhamdulillah. The song I wrote whilst I was on Hajj over 10 years ago, and we had the most amazing view of the mountains around the Kaaba. Bismillah. Oh, mountains of Mecca, what did you see? When a mother cried out with a sunny smile, and they were depending solely on their Lord, when out of the earth a blessing appeared. Mountains of Mecca, what can you say of the day that Abraham passed away, and he was instructed by God to build a house of peace where people pray, and they will come and freely camel and out of every ravine for the purpose of praising Allah, to glorify Allah. O mountains of Mecca, what can you tell of the day that stones from the sky fell, destroying an army determined to break the house of Allah that Abraham built? O mountains of Mecca, how was the dawn on the day that my Prophet Muhammad was born? How did it feel knowing he was to be the last and most beloved of all? Rasul of Allah, Nabi of Allah. O mountains of Mecca, you were there
When the Prophet Muhammad climbed down in despair, engraved in his heart were the words of his Lord. To all of mankind, this was his call. La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. O people, praise only Allah, glorify Allah. O mountains of Mecca, how did you mourn on the day that the beloved returned to his Lord? And up till the last breath escaped from his lips, he prayed that his ummah would find success. O mountains of Mecca, how will it feel when the earth shall quake and tremble with fear, and we shall be gathered together to stand in the court of Allah with our deeds at hand? Oh, how we pray that on that day we'll be with those to whom Allah will say, peace be with you, I am pleased with you. O mountains of Mecca, bear witness that I, to the oneness of Allah do I testify. For all that he's given me, how can I deny? My purpose in life should be only to cry, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. There is no God but Allah, Muhammad is his messenger. La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. There is no God but Allah, Muhammad is his messenger.
JazakAllah khair. Thank you so much.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. MashaAllah indeed. Zain, just... MashaAllah Zain, and I think there's no question, Zain's not just from our community, but he's renowned, world renowned, globally renowned in terms of what he does. So let's give him some applause as well. An acknowledgement to that. Thank you. Now we'll have a few speakers and we can limit them to about 3 minutes or so each because of time constraints. I'll call upon the CEO of SABIC. That's the acronym for the Saudi Arabia Basic Industries Corporation. I've been told it's what? One of the top three global companies in the world, but with huge interest in our country. So thank you for the investment. And that's Iyad Al-Gharawi, if I can get your attention, please. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace be upon you all. It's an honor to be in front of you today. It's equally a pleasure, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, and all of you are brothers and sisters. Actually, today I'm coming here in my capacity as a Saudi citizen, not general manager for SABIC South Africa. I performed Hajj 20 years ago, and Brother Yusuf met me in the office a couple of weeks ago, and he was showing me the pictures. And it did not only remind me of my experience in Hajj, it reminded me of my experience. Since I performed Hajj, Alhamdulillah, I was privileged to travel the globe because of my business requirements. I have also lived in a couple of other countries, and now I'm living in South Africa. Hajj is a unique experience, and whoever have tried it before, you would know how Hajj is more than part of the religion. It's a humanity gathering. It's a unique experience for you to visualize how humanity should behave and should perform. Unfortunately, we are living in an era where media is negative. You see in the media something different from what you experience in life. And when I saw these pictures, I said, I will support this book, personally. I will advertise for it in the media. I will talk about it in my own community, and I'll talk about it in my community when I go back home. It is a positive book that brings positive energy and positive vibration that how humanity should be working together, and how humanity should be always, not only Muslims, but all humanity should be together performing. I thank you, Brother Yusuf. I thank all of you, and God bless you.
Jazakallah shukran for that, Tiyad. We asked for 3 minutes, you gave us two, so it's like a discount of 1 minute, right? Most appreciated. Maybe the next performer will steal the minute, I don't know. We South Africa is very blessed with having, I think, outstanding orators, really. And I mean, many of them come from the political space and the struggle space. And that resonates once again with hashtag Freeze Must Fall, you know, once again grabbing the national attention. But if you go back to all those years ago, the name Mswati Mbuli was uppermost. An outstanding orator, a performer, a poet, but a performing artist of note. And I think, therefore, we are absolutely honored to have Mswati Mbuli here to say a few words, to recite for us. Thank you.
Shall I say, all protocols observed to be on the safe side. Thank you, Yusuf, for inviting me, us. We come a long way. I'm more proud to see Zane Bika. He's bigger than, greater than Michael Jackson, Zane Bika. Can check him, he's bigger than Michael Jackson. We need to advertise the book and advertise Zane Bika. Yusuf gave me something very, I had to, as per command, to do as he requested me to do. I would do it for you. It's for you to choose. You chose to be here than to be elsewhere. People choose Africa. People choose Arabs. People choose alliance than aggression. People choose amalgamation than acrimony. People choose Allah. People choose bonding than bondage. People choose brilliance than bickering. People choose Bishop Tutu than Boko Haram. People choose Buddhism. People choose Bayasunodi. Choose baptism. People choose communication than confrontation. People choose credentials than crime. People choose Christ, not corruption. Choose Christianity. People choose dancing than drugs. People choose emancipation. Choose democracy than dictatorship. People choose education than it all. People choose emancipation than elimination or ethnicity. People choose fairness than fraud. People choose federations than feuds. People choose free education. Yes, check, fees must fall. People choose Fatima Mir. People choose good governance. People choose graduates than gangsters. People choose God than prophets of doom that feed you with grass, petrol, and snakes. People choose Mahatma Gandhi. People choose holiness than HIV. People choose hard workers than hypocrites. People choose Holy Trinity than hatred. People choose Hindu, Muslim. People choose intelligence than impunity. People choose investments than impediment. People choose Islam. People choose joy than jealous. People choose job creators than job killers. People choose justice, Jesus. People choose knowledge than knives. People choose Koi Koi and Sun People. People choose Kwame Nkrumah. People choose Hare Krishna. People choose love than lust. People choose legislation than lawlessness. People choose lights than load shedding. People choose Lillian Ngoyi. People choose music than murder. People choose maturity than mischief. People choose mine workers, not Marikana massacre. People choose Muslims. People choose Mecca. People choose nation building, networking, not nepotism. People choose Nelson Mandela, Prophet Muhammad. People choose obedience than obstruction, outreach than onslaught. People choose Oliver Tambo, Olympics. People choose prayers than pornography. People choose prayers than prostitution. People choose patriotism than plunder. People choose prosperity than piracy. People choose Palestinians. People choose peace than prejudice. People choose quality than quantity. People choose qualifications than quarrels. People choose romance than rape. People choose roses than rape. People choose romance, roses than racism. People choose reconciliation. People choose scholarships than scandals. People choose sanity than scandals. People choose salvation. People choose the shame religion. People choose sacrament than satanism. People choose sports. People choose teachers than traitors. People choose training than travesty. People choose Timbuktu than tribalism. People choose tolerance. People choose Ubuntu than Ubulwane. People choose Ubuntu unity. People choose violins than violence. People choose vitamins than vodka. People choose Victoria Mkenge. People choose Isqaqambich than xenophobia. People choose Afro xenophobia. People choose Isqaqambich than xenophobia or Afrophobia. People choose Vusi Klimba. Choose Malcolm X. People choose Yasser Arafat than the yoke. People choose wisdom than war. People choose wisdom than witchcraft. People choose worship. People choose a zebra than a zombie. People choose Yusuf Abramjee. Choose Yusuf Abramjee. Yusuf Abramjee.
So who chooses Mzwakhe Mbuli? Well, there you are. Mzwakhe, thank you so much for that. We choose you, and I think you're right. It's Choose Day, C-H-O-O-S-E, Choose Day. We all make choices. And you know the good thing about today? Seriously, the one thing we have in common, whatever we've come here for, the common denominator is Yusuf Abramjee, and the common denominator is Hajj, right? And the other common denominator is we are South Africans. And what's important when we're seated here today, as we are now, and when we go back home, the choices we make will determine where South Africa lands up as a nation. Those of you who know me know that I feel strongly about this dream of a champion South Africa, moving from where we are now to where we want to be. Do we want to be mid-table, or do we want to be the best nation on earth? That decision is premised upon what every one of you chooses. So it is Tuesday. Thank you so much for that. I think he's seated right at the back, Kevin Ritchie. But when you were the Star newspaper, we will hunt you down because we need coverage. And I think most of us will know that besides this being the preeminent newspaper in our city, and Kevin, as you're walking up, you will know it's been my favorite newspaper since I was 5 years old, genuinely. But very importantly, it is a newspaper that we need, especially from this predominantly Muslim community, to spread a message to make it mainstream. And Yusuf's story of Hajj, when it was put in the Star newspaper, on the Saturday Star, it became mainstream. For allowing that to happen, do we need to thank an editor? I don't know. Anyway, here's Kevin Ritchie, editor of the Star.
Welcome to all of you, and thank you very much for the privilege to be here. And Ashraf, absolutely no. Please don't thank me for doing what is absolutely natural. Yusuf is my brother. We have been friends for a very long time, and when we look at the story of Hajj and we look at what Yusuf did, you know, Khadija was saying this was a normal Hajj. It wasn't. Yusuf went on it. And what he did immediately was that he allowed us, and he has so many friends, of whom I'm only one, to share in this growing spirituality and the spiritual journey that he had, and to share in something that is often denied for those of us who are of the faith, but not of Islam. And it is an incredibly special journey that we were, the non-Muslims, were allowed to share with him, and to share this fantastic gift of this overarching humanity and this gift of humanity. But Yusuf being Yusuf, it didn't end there. He looked around, you know, we all remember him from Lead SA, and he's one of the few people, I think, that has ever managed to leave an institution, and I hope you won't be embarrassed by me saying this, but has proved himself almost to be as big as what he launched, which was Lead SA, because today he calls himself an activist, a South African activist, and he is so much of that. And there he was in Saudi, and he saw other pilgrims who were not as well off, who were struggling to perform that fifth pillar of their faith. And he reached out all the way back here to South Africa, specifically to the Muslim community, and he raised an incredible amount of funds to alleviate the plight of those pilgrims. And even then, when he got back, and we were all following him now, we were following his videos, we were following his photographs and his posts, and now he has brought this book that we can all share, not just the Muslim community, our Muslim brothers and sisters, but the entire South Africa, and indeed further. And I hope that the money that is raised from the sales of these books will go towards making it possible for everybody who needs to be able to make this incredible journey. But most of all, it was and as I said, Yusuf just can't help himself. So no sooner had he come back here than there was, as you know, a problem around the fees. This was another fees must fall, but this was now Hajj and Umrah fees must fall. And Yusuf took this on with his usual aplomb. And Yusuf doesn't burn things, and he doesn't threaten people. He just gets things done. So I know that he has all our prayers and hopes that he will succeed in this, his latest venture, to make it possible to have the decision where these fees have gone up dramatically reduced. Thank you very much for the opportunity and for being here today.
Gavin Ritchie of the Star, some applause for him as well, please. Thank you. Delivered on a silver platter, so I've noticed. Mm. So who's been, I asked you guys earlier about who's got cell phones, and everybody picked up their hands, right? You still have your cell phones, you haven't lost it. Who's been tweeting, Facebooking, Instagramming using hashtag Abramjee on Hajj? Who's been doing it? That's like a quarter. The power of a quarter. If a quarter people can get Abramjee and Hajj to trend, which you've just done, imagine if the whole hall does that. So, okay, well done. You've done that already. All right. Now the team from Ubuntu Islam to perform for us. And the name says it all, isn't it? It's like a double barreled confirmation or affirmation, Ubuntu Islam.
Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I came here earlier on, they were not here. When they got here, I felt like giving them a hot clap. for being late.
I was still making dua for Yusuf.
I can't go into Hajj. That is just us saying, inshallah, if Allah is, Allah will give us Jannat, which is paradise.
It's inspired by Yusuf's book. We'll perform a song called Tawbah. You know, amongst the shurut of Tawbah, of Hajj, is that you welcome Hajj with Tawbah. So inshallah, we'll do a song on Tawbah, inshallah.
Hum, hum, ha, hum, hum, ha, hum, hum, ha, hum. Hum, hum, ha, hum, hum, ha, hum. Hum, 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 created me from nothing, gave me everything, including your deep, but still I go against your will. Oh Allah, beg your forgiveness, for your past, present, and future sins. What will I become with all your mercy? Oh, your Lord of great King of all kings, the most merciful, the most kind.
I live my life as if tomorrow is guaranteed, as if in my right hand I will receive my book of deeds. Oh Allah, the provider, oh the most kind, you still provide for me. I go astray, neglect my duties as a Muslim. I seem to forget that you hear and see everything. One a'udhu billah, sometimes I even falter my swalah. Please forgive me before swalah is made for me. Toba, 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 pardon me, Allah. Toba, 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 pardon me, Allah.
Umangise bunzimeni uAllah wenza impilo yami belula. Noma nginokuphuma endleleni sometimes. Allah unomusa onesihawu, wanginika amehlo ukuthi ngibone ubukhulu bakho. Allah, Allah, Allah. Allah unomusa onesihawu, wangitholela ngibekezelela ngibonisa ukukhanya. Allah, Allah, yeah. Tawba, tawba, pardni Allah. Tawba, 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 pardni Allah.
Jazakallah.
MashaAllah, thank you. Well done. Applause for them, more applause. Thank you so much. It's interesting. I mean, Tawbah is essentially repentance, right? I've never seen people so happy making tawbah, but you know, Yusuf's around, lots of strange things happen in this place here, right? So let me ask you this. I asked you earlier on about why, you know, did you want to be here? And I think most of you said, yes, that's exactly where we want to be, right? But why did you want to be here? Anybody wants to like blurt out why are you here? You're here because of who? Yeah? Well, that may be one reason, but the more important one, quite honestly, is the common thread is Yusuf Abramjee, isn't it? Okay. So we can do two things. You can make dua that he comes on and says something. Because isn't it amazing? We've had a function. We've been speaking for just over an hour. And a motor mouth called Yusuf Abramjee has said nothing. It's incredible. He said absolutely nothing. Now, to get him on here, we can either do like that to say, come on. Or hold it. I haven't even called you on. Yeah. Okay. We can either do that or we can do like a full 30 seconds of applause to get him on here. Can we do that? 30 seconds of applause. Non-stop. All right. Okay. I think you've made your points. You want him to be here. Yusuf, you better hear this. When Yusuf asked me to be the MC for this event, I asked him which date, and he said today, and he said 5 o'clock. And I said, Yusuf, you know, you do lots of things, I know that. But clearly you don't follow soccer, isn't it? He said, why? I said, Man United versus Chelsea, 5 o'clock. I said, it's important to me to follow Man United. And Yusuf comes back and he says, you know, Ashraf, did you ever think about it? Hajj is Man United. It's mankind united. So Ashraf, make your choice. Man United as in Manchester or the real Man United, which is mankind united. The choice is pretty obvious. He's done many things in his life, from a journalist to a crime fighter to a Twitter king to a social activist to being a friend to just about everybody else. I would call you a champion South African, but I think the title that matters most right now is Al-Hajj Yusuf Abramjee.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Good afternoon. Thank you, program director, my dear friend. What you forgot to mention is that Hajj is not only Man United, it's also a national sport because it's part of our religion. Ladies and gentlemen, let me first of all thank you for coming to join this very important launch. Too many friends to mention. All I can say is that I'm really honored that you are supporting this great cause. Let me very briefly sketch the background to Hajj 2016. I've been wanting to go with the family for Hajj over many, many years. And I applied to SAHUK, the South African Hajj and Umrah Council. And you know, if you're not good with SAHUK, they won't give you a visa. So I waited for 8 years, and this year my visa didn't come through, and I phoned Shaheen Esop, the chairman of SAHUK. I said, Shaheen, after 8 years, surely I deserve a visa. And he said to me, you don't need a visa because you can go straight to the Saudi embassy, they will give you a visa. So why deprive three or other four people for a visa when you can go directly? Because previously I'd been invited through the King's program for Hajj, I refused, and also as a journalist, I refused because the first Hajj, you want to go on your own. And Alhamdulillah, after writing a letter to my dear friend, the ambassador, he afforded us courtesy visas within 10 minutes of the email going to him. Ladies and gentlemen, when I wanted to go for Hajj, the intention wasn't to go and tweet, wasn't to go and Facebook, and wasn't to come and do a coffee table book. When I arrived before I left, the Saudi Arabian ambassador phoned, he said, I did you a favor, I gave you a visa, can you do me one favor? We have a Saudi Arabian television crew in South Africa from Saudi TV One. They want to follow a pilgrim right from his home, right into the airport in OR Tambo, on the plane, into Mecca, and then they will leave you to perform your Hajj. And I reluctantly agreed. And they spent 3 days with me here. They were on the plane with me. And when they came to Jeddah, we did some more filming and the documentary was screened following a pilgrim from the most southern tip of Africa. When I arrived in Jeddah airport, I put a photo on Twitter to say I've arrived in Jeddah airport. And this is the airport, what a great facility. And then my dear friend Ashraf Garda said, you know, I do the media show on SAFM every Sunday. Why don't you use the hashtag Abramjee on Hajj? And the rest is history. We used the hashtag, and throughout the journey, we documented this particular Hajj 2016, Mr. Minister. When I came back, and by the way, all the photographs you're seeing on this book was taken on an iPhone, believe it or not. I didn't even take a camera along. Who's got an iPhone 6S here? Please come forward. Give him my iPhone 6 cover there, Yasin. Give him a cover, please, and something from the iStore. The iStore, by the way, sponsored some giveaway, so well done to you. Anyone wants an iPhone 6 cover or a lens, they speak to Yasin. Andy Mashaila, give him one as well. When I got back, Kevin, I had 1,500 pictures I took over the period on my iPhone, and I said, yes, is this capacity on this iPhone, Mr. Minister, Trish, is very, very small. And I said to my dear friend Yasin, and we were involved in Operation Hydrate, he's my brother, we part of our family, and I said, Yasin, do me one favor, take these 1,500 photos and just download them on your Apple and store them away because I can't take the capacity of the photos I had. And he came back to me the next day, he said, I'm not going to allow these photos to disappear. I think we must make a coffee table book. And I laughed at him, and I said, look at the quality. I mean, how can you take an iPhone quality and going to do a book? And he said, leave it to me. He then went to a guy called Muhammad Ismail from Custom Art, who agreed to do it free of charge. We got hold of Farouk Hussein, our co-writer and our contributor. Then I got hold of my niece, the new editor of the Mail and Guardian, and I said, we are not paying you. I want you to edit the book. And believe it or not, we arrived back in South Africa on the 17th of last month, and here we are today, the book is being published. 400 photographs depicting the journey. Some of the photographs, Kevin, thanks to Yazid Kamaldeen, who went on Hajj this year as a reporter for the Weekend Argus, and thanks to my friends from ITV, Farad Umar, Hafez Zahir was here, Parvez Zunaid. And by the way, ITV also caught me in the mix because they invited me for an interview on the first night for the opening broadcast. And when I did the interview, they said, you are now presenting while we are here. And I then got in and I did some voluntary work for them. Ladies and gentlemen, this book is not to make money for me nor for anyone else. The proceeds are going to OCAF South Africa and to Crescent Lifestyle for the Hajj Wakaf. This book will not be a success, and we know what charity means and we know we have to give charity. It's not only about giving money to charity, Minister Hanekom, distinguished guest. It's about building social cohesion. It's about us coming together. You know this religion of Islam, we are called terrorists, Janine. We are called Boko Haram. When we fight there in Valhalla for the mosque, they call us all different names. And what we are showing the world through the Hajj is that irrespective of whether you're Muslim, Christian, Hindu, Jewish, or any other faith, Hajj is about bringing people together. When you sit in Arafat or you sit in Mina, and you've got two pieces of white cloth called the Ihram, next to you might be a judge from Kenya, on your left-hand side might be a school teacher from Afghanistan. Behind you might be a social worker from Barbados, and in front of you might be an unemployed person from Nigeria. At that point, during the Hajj period, we are all equal, no titles. Be it as it may, during the journey, we make a lot of friends. And you know, we South Africans also buy a lay particular and we like to sleep in the five-star hotels. And every time we go and pray at the Grand Mosque, we go past and we see hundreds of pilgrims sleeping on the floor from all parts of the world. Many of them have no food. And I met a new friend along the journey. His name is Mubin Adam, together with his lovely wife, Leila. Where is Mubin? Mubin, stand up there, please. Stand up there for a moment. That is Mubin, my fellow Haji. And Mubin and I walk, and I said, Mubin, look at these poor people. They don't have food. Why don't we do something? And Mubin and I said, we'll put 1,000 Saudi riyals, 4,000 rand. We'll buy food. The 2,000 then grew to 250,000 rand in 24 hours. And thanks to all my fellow Hajis that are here today, Muhammad, Ismail, I can go on with the names. We all rallied together, people, thanks to Twitter and Facebook and WhatsApp group. And thanks to Yasin for raising the funds here, we raised 250,000 in 24 hours. We fed 9,000 people, and we bought a horse and trailer truck full of juice and milk, and we gave it out on Arafat during the 52 degrees heat that we saw during that particular period. Where's Rafiq Ganga, the travel agent? Rafiq Ganga, the travel agent, is here, my dear friend. He helped us. He caught hold of a humanitarian in Mecca. he helped us to get all the resources and to buy it together. Fazila Malik, sister, are you here from? She made sure she looked after us. I wasn't part of her group. She organized a South African braai before we left. She took me for a lovely breakfast. And that is the spread that we have, ladies and gentlemen, about Hajj. Is to make sure that we bring peace, we bring unity, we come together and we are one. And I hope through the proceeds of this book, Brother Kaji, we'll be able to take many people on Hajj. I've got one appeal to President Zuma, and I know President Zuma has taken this to the King during his official state visit. And he said to them, we only have a quota of 1,950 people. Can you please increase it to 2,000, to 3,000? And the King said to him, I'll come back to you, and we hope, inshallah, next year, Mr. Minister, through your influence, through our ambassadors, Consul General, is to say, let us try to give South Africans an opportunity to take more people on Hajj, a very, very important pillar that we have to perform. Yes, I'll be failing in my duty. Umrah fees must fall. We met Durko, Ambassador Mohammed Abbas Khan, Consul General Shuaib Kasu, the support of Idris Ibrahim and other officials. We met the head of the Gulf State. We gave our case. For us to pay 10,000 rand for a visa, it's going to be unbearable. And we really have to fight this cause. And we keep on praying that the Almighty Allah makes it easy for us to undertake this journey without making and paying 10,000 rand for a visa. I don't want to bring Minister Hannah come in there because he wants to bring the Saudis also here to Cape Town and to Joburg. So we'll leave him out of the politics. We will fight that cause. Ladies and gentlemen, before I leave, Yasin told me, please sell as many books as you can. We sold 500 books online by this morning. We have a few, we've got about 100 left, so if you can please sign up. If they can't give you a physical copy today, Asghar from Courier Direct will courier it for you free of charge to your house this week. And my appeal to you, everyone, is don't buy one book. Do me a favor, don't buy one book, buy two or more. Because at the end of the day, it's going for a good cause. Now, let me, in conclusion, and Yasin said to me, yes, you're a good salesman. He said to me, please sell a few books, because the one call we've had, Sheikh Dawood Sampson from Cape Town, Parkwood, Bollywood, mosque down there, he said to me, we have to give charity with the right hand, the left hand mustn't know. We've had a lot of requests from townships, from rural areas, from mosques, from churches, believe it or not, is to say, please donate us a book. For every book that we donate, 750 rand, we're paying the proceeds, the printers, as Bashir Hafeji gave it to us at under cost price. We still have to give Okaf and Crescent Lifestyle the proceeds. So there's a need to sponsor 150 books that we can donate to libraries, to NGOs. And Minister Nati Mtetwa will join me in Cape Town on the 6th of November at the Center for the Library, where we're launching in Cape Town. Last night, I drove to a function, Sultan Bawu down the road, and they asked me to be the MC, and I normally don't charge to do charity work for MCing. And on the highway, Yasin stopped. He said, the first book has arrived. I have to give you the first book. And I took the first book, I took it in the car, and I said, wow, what a wonderful job everyone did. And when I came to the function, they raised 1.1 million, and they were still short of money. And I said, you know what, I'll give you this book. I'll donate it to Sultan Bawu, go and auction it off. If we can get 750 rand, we'll be lucky. The book went on auction, and I said all the proceeds can go to Sultan Bawu for dialysis, for cataracts, for drug rehabilitation. And the book then sold for 50,000 rand. And the guy that bought it, Buti Tayop, I hope he's here. Buti Tayop, are you here? Please come forward. This man paid 50,000 rand for Abramjee's book. Buti Tayo, please come forward. Yasin, you must give him a nice case for his book that I signed last night. We might add another 50 grand to the bill in any event. This man, ladies and gentlemen, in the true spirit of what South Africa is about, he paid 50,000 rand for Abramjee on Hajj, and he knows the proceeds are going for Sultan Bawu, and whether it is Auka or Crescent Lifestyle, this is the man that paid 50,000 rand for the first book of the press. No. You said I must say it, you say it. Say it.
Jazakallah, Uncle Yusuf.
For me, Uncle.
You're quite an inspiration to all of us. We've all been following you for many years. And may Allah choose us to have good spirit to follow leaders like you. All right, and a simple words of encouragement to love, to learn, to love, and to lead a legacy. And I think, Uncle Yusuf, you stand up to those that particular phrase. May Allah bless you and continue to improve you and grow our ummah and humanity at large. Alhamdulillah.
How many books have you counted for the library? How many books have you counted for the library? How many books are you buying for the library?
Whatever you say. 11 books.
10,000 rand he'll add to the library collection to donate books to libraries. Shukran. Yasin, you can give him another book free as well, please, man. 10,000 rand, you can, Yasin, will you please box it for him? Shukran, brother Bhuti. 10,000 rand, Molana Pelwan, please give him the credit card machine. The spirit of South Africa, people donate, minister, dignitaries, a lot of hard time. Uncle Said Mia, are you here? Or are the sons here, Dr. Mia? Where is the Dr. Mia family? They've asked me to please add them to the list. They're donating 10,000 rand to the library project. Thank you very much for that. Uncle Haji Kitkat phoned me and said, add me for 20,000 rand to donate books to libraries. We'll add you on there. Uncle Harun Kala from MCA, where are you? Where's Uncle Harun Kala? No, let him come to the front here. He bought 50 books for MCA products, 37,000 rand. He's also an active member of OCAF. He got me to co-host on ITV during Ramadan. We raised how much for OCAF? 15 million rand we raised in 4 or 5 hours for OCAF. Call Uncle Harun Kala to the front. Where is he? I said, I hope he hasn't run away. He's going to pay more tax. We'll see if we can get him involved. Rafiq Proroof has bought 30 books. Imtiaz Timol, where's Imtiaz Timol? Zaid Surti's brother-in-law. Imtiaz Timol has bought 30 books for 23,000 rand. Akbar Ghani from Laudium, 5,000 rand. But now is the most important part. Brother Zainuddin Kaji, please come forward. Please stand here. You're not giving any speeches, just stand there. Al-Farnaz from Crescent Lifestyle, please come forward. These are the two beneficiaries where the proceeds of this book is going to. Please put your hands together. Where is he calling here? Where's the CEO of FNB Banking? Aman Mohammed, where are you? Come here, Aman. Where's Stacy Lee Boland, the innovation manager for FNB? Come here, Stacy, my dear friend. Even the Jews are my friend. Oh, I shouldn't be saying that, Stacy. Please come forward, Stacy. My best friends, by the way, are members of the Jewish community, for the record. Stacy and I come a very long way. She's the innovation manager for FNB. So when you see the fingerprint on the app, you must know that Stacy has put it together. Stacy is the person that has put FNB on the map as well. How many books are you buying, Aman?
Assalamu alaikum. We'll take 50, Yusuf.
Mashallah. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, Stacy. Appreciate it. 50 books for FNB, Islamic Banking, we appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you, Stacy. Thank you, Aman. Okay, before I take my seat, I talk to Lord, the minister wants to talk. Ladies and gentlemen, before we end, we have to auction off 3 books for the balance of the library. Yasin, bring me those 3 boxes together. The book costs 750 rand. The casing costs 5,000 rand. It's handmade. Anyone wants to bid 50,000, oh, let's start off with less, 10,000 rand? 10,000 rand to the school library fund. Just shout your name out there before. Zaid Surti, where are you? Come, Surti, come. Haagen-Dazs ice cream we buy every Saturday. We can take 1% of the profit. Zaid Surti, 10,000 rand, can I put you down? Zaid Surti, thank you. Who's giving us 20,000 rand? Please put up your hand. Where's Faisal Surti? Yes, thank you. What's your name, brother? Ibrahim Pier, 20,000 rand. We can double that. Let's make, you know, I don't want to work with 1 and 2,000 rand. Who's giving us 50,000 rand? Come on, let's call it a day. 50,000 rand? Kevin, will you put the person's photo in the paper tomorrow? Anyone wants to pay 50 grand for school libraries, my brothers? That's all we're asking for. Let's donate for a good cause. I'm jumping too much. 20 grand we've got. 25 grand. Anyone for 25,000? Yasin, can you see them? My eyes are not too good. 25,000 rand. Brother, please come forward. We'll give it to you for 20,000. Please come forward. Thank you very much. Put your hands together for this gentleman who is paying 20,000 rand. These books are going to people in need. You see, that is how South Africans give, ladies and gentlemen. What's your company's name again? Els Hardware. If you need any equipment, roof equipment, building equipment, Els Hardware is a place. Thank you very much. All right, we've got two more left. Very quickly, we want to have high tea and we want to pray and we want to go home. Who's paying 10,000 rand for the remaining one or two? Yes, please. I heard something named Yasin. Who's shouting there? We got 10,000 rand. Thank you very much. 20,000 rand? 20,000 rand for a Hajj workoff. Let's make it easy for somebody to go for Hajj next year, inshallah. We got a name? 20,000? Gee, this audience is too quiet. Thank you very much. We've got 20,000 rand. Have we got 25,000 rand? 25,000 rand, Zainul, can you see? Going once, going twice, going three times. Thank you very much. Please come forward. 20,000 rand we have for the other one. Thank you very much for your support. Please come forward, my respected brother or sister that put up your hand. You want to remain anonymous, come forward. We'll take your name privately, but we'll see your face. Where's Muhammad from Otto Style? AB Karam, are you here? Muhammad Dada. Faisal Surti, Muhammad Surti, Muhammad Mayat. Yasin, where's all your rich friends from Houghton, Yemen? Yes. Did we give the gentleman his book for 20,000? No, not yet. The person that put a bid for 20,000, please come forward. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Bashir from Neon Printers, who printed, is giving us 100 books for free. Thank you, Bashir. Bye. Please come forward. Let me tell you the story about these people. They're from my hometown of Erasmia. We needed wool for Carolyn Stain. Where's Naeem Bhai? Please come here. Come here, uncle. We wanted wool. He's got a big wool importing company, Mr. Minister. We wanted blankets for 67 blankets. We wanted wool for 67 blankets. This uncle came forward and his company donated 14 million rand worth of wool. 14 million rand worth of wool. And the condition he made, doctor, by the way, she's a medical doctor that worked with Zain's father, trained her. Uncle Poppy Rashid Bika trained Raisa. Come forward, uncle name. He donated 14 million rand worth of wool to Carolyn's 1067 Blackers Cav. And when I went to him, next year we're breaking the record again. I said, how many more million rand of wool you donating next year? He said, whatever you need. Am I right? You'll agree 10,000 is a bit low for that, Uncle Lane? 20,000 rand. Shukran, put your hands together. 20,000 rand. Thank you, Dr. Raisa. Thank you, Uncle Lane. We really appreciate your support and may the Almighty reward you abundantly. Shukran. Thank you very much. Have we got any more to auction?
Muhammad Dada, 10,000.
Muhammad Dada, thank you very much. Is it... He doesn't want to come up. Muhammad, thank you very much. Where's Shoniz? By the way, his wife Shoniz is making the casings. Sharona. Sharona is making the casings. 10,000 rand. Yes, Suleiman. Dr. Ismail Mita, please come. Hang on. Dr. Ismail Mita, please come to the front. Here, your program gaan te lang. Dr. Ismail Mita, please come forward quickly. Please, my doc, run. You are a cyclist. Dr. Ismail Mita is a dear friend of mine. He runs a hospital, Mr. Minister, on the East Rand. He's also the chairman of the Centen Islamic Society. He's a dear friend of mine. He's a big cyclist. He does a lot of charity work. We're going to be selling him this book for how much, Yasin? Dr. Mita, how much are you paying for this book?
He has to break last night's record.
You have to break last night's record. How much are you paying for this book? For charity?
Can start the auction now.
50,000 rand from Dr. Mita, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry? Who? Zaid Surti and Mohammed Mayet, another 50 or what?
No, Mita Asa split it.
That's fine. All right, do me a favor, we'll split it how you want to, just give my 50 grand, please, man. Thank you, Dr. Mita. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the spirit of Ubuntu. Thank you very much, brothers.
They're splitting it, but they can't split the book, so they need to come in.
Yeah, you can't split the book, so you need to buy more books. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I think we've exceeded 150 books that we were targeting. Shukran, thank you. We're probably going to, Yasin, how many books we'll be donating? Over 200, inshallah. Kariziat Patel, where are you? Hey, my dear friend, this man's got a lovely voice, eh? When he goes all over the world, he does a humanitarian work. I always see him on Twitter and Facebook. And Kariziat said to me, don't mention my name, so I'll mention his name. Kariziat Patel, the Al Imdad Foundation will be buying a number of books and distributing it, inshallah, to madrasas and libraries within the areas of where they work. They'll give the amount, inshallah, next week. Please convey our thanks to the Al Imdad Foundation. Ladies and gentlemen, my time is up. Thank you for your support. Let me end off by saying that I brought the Minister of Tourism here for one reason. Not only because he's my friend. You know, this guy is very fit. Derek Hanekom is very, very fit. He got me into trouble in the Gandhi Walk because Ismail Bhai Vadi decided to do the 5Ks. And I said that, you know what, I'll probably do the 5Ks. And Minister Hanekom said to me when we were walking in Lanesia, together with a guy called Tigari, we went and we were walking. I said, you know what, I'll bail out after 5Ks. And you won't believe it. The minister walked 15Ks and he felt as fit as he could. And I was forced to finish 15Ks as well. But Minister Hanekom is a good leader who inspires all of us. He's a man that we stand up and look to for inspiration and for leadership. He will do what is right for South Africa. He will do what is right for tourism. And that is why, ladies and gentlemen, it's important for us as South Africans to support people like Minister Derek Hanekom to make sure that we take South Africa forward and we make sure that we contribute to the spirit of Ubuntu. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thanks, Yusuf. You do exactly what we expect you to do, right? And I think thanks to the audience here, you've been superb. It's not the end of it all. We're almost done. We know that. But superb in terms of your contribution. Because let's go back to the issue. It's the Hajj book, or Abramjee on Hajj, but it is there to impact on other people. And your contributions, whether it's the 750 or the 50,000, will impact on other people, right? And for that, we thank you. Right, let me now call upon the South African Consul General to Saudi Arabia. We're going to have the two of them coming up back to back, just 3 minutes before we wrap up, almost towards the end. The Consul General, Shoaib Kausar.
Program Director, Minister Hanekom, Mr. Ismail Vadi, Yusuf Abramjee, my colleagues, Mohammed Khan, Ibrahim Idris, brothers and sisters, distinguished guests, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It is not unusual for us to have a VIP guest during Hajj. 2 years ago, I think we had Deputy Minister Enver Surti for Hajj, and he wanted a very quiet Hajj. Last year, we had Brother Hashim Amla for Hajj, and he also wanted a very quiet Hajj. This year, we got the message Yusuf Abramjee was coming. Initially, when we got the message, we thought, let's just back off, and maybe he wants a quiet Hajj too. So we just left him alone, and a few days later, we got this email, Dear Consul General Shoaib Kausar, and we knew, here comes trouble. But Alhamdulillah, Yusuf was there, and he brought the spirit of Hajj across to everyone all over the world. He has great energy, great enthusiasm, and a great attitude. And I think people have responded to that, and I'm happy to see the spirit of this Hajj here. But Hajj and Umrah is a partnership between the South African government, the Saudi kingdom, the Hajj and Umrah Council, the agents, and the Hujjaj from all over the world. And this partnership ensures that Hajj takes place in an orderly and in a successful way. And we want to take this opportunity to thank the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia for all their efforts in maintaining the two harams and in doing all the work they do for the Hujjaj. We appreciate that. at the same time, we take the opportunity of thanking our government, Minister, for maintaining the consulate in Jeddah. One of its primary functions is to support Hajj and Umrah. And there's some 42,000 South Africans who come annually to the Kingdom for Hajj and Umrah. The Hajj and Umrah Council and the Hajj Mission in particular spend 8 to 9 weeks every year support doing the logistics and being ready there to assist the Hujjaj who come for the 6 weeks or 5 weeks of Hajj. It's a thankless job. They leave their families for a small stipend of 110 riyals only per day. So they do a great job, and often I have the opportunity of thanking them in the Kingdom, but never the opportunity arises to thank them here in person. So all those brothers of the Sahuk, thank you very much for all your efforts. I know that South Africans want the numbers of Hujjaj to increase, and I know we have a waiting list of almost 18 or 19,000 first-time Hujjaj. Alhamdulillah, inshallah, our numbers will increase. But just to put this in perspective, the Malaysians have 120,000 Hujjaj who come every year, but they have a waiting list of 80 years. So gives you an appreciation of just how difficult the task is of having some kind of a balance between everyone coming for Hajj from all the different nations of the world. But Alhamdulillah, we do have South Africans there, and hopefully this will continue. But Yusuf, thank you for bringing this event to all of us, and for bringing the Hajj and the experience of Hajj to all of us. We appreciate it. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum.
Thanks for that message, Consul General. Most appreciated. Let me now call upon South Africa's acting ambassador to Saudi Arabia. That's Ambassador Mohammed Abbas Khan.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I was asked to say a few words, and I think everybody has said more than me than I could ever say. So I'm not going to repeat what everybody has said. Safe to say that Hajj is, as we know, the fifth pillar of Islam, very important to us as Muslims. When I was studying in Cape Town, I got entwined with the culture of the Hajj preparedness by the Cape Townian Hujjaj. And there was a build-up days before the actual departure from all these people going for this wonderful and exhilarating ritual. Hajj, as we know, is a very important part of our lives as Muslims. I've often sat and listened to people as they gave experiences of their Hajj, how they expected things to happen, their anticipation, their apprehension of what Hajj is all about. And then we listen to how these people explain their Hajj experience, and we wonder if we would ever go and how our experience of this journey would be. And Alhamdulillah, in 1998, I had my first experience. And the only time you experience Hajj fully is when you actually go there in person and you perform the rituals. The first time you enter the Haram and you look at the Kaaba, you become emotional. You look at this Kaaba, this Qibla that you looked at all your life, that you prayed to, and it hits you. You cry. You don't know what to do. Your soul is aflame with ibadat, with emotion. This is the Kaaba that you've stood and you've made dua and you've made dhikr and you made whatever, and this is the Qibla, the direction you faced. And here you stand in front of this holy Kaaba. It is now your turn, your experience. And that experience lives with you forever. You can go to Mauritius, you can go to Los Angeles, you go to wherever, you can go to an holiday, but you will never forget the experience of Hajj, ever. It is one thing that you want to go to often, over and over and over. When I went for Hajj, I forgot all about Greece and Mauritius and whatever. Every year it was Umrah. Umrah. And that is what we go for. Now in this book, that Yusuf has. For those who has not been on Hajj before, let it be an inspiration and a motivation. When you page and thumb through those pages to see all those places, let it be an emotional experience for you too, as it was for me. And for those who've been on Hajj before, let it be that memorable experience once again, when you page through those books, page for page, and you remember your words, labbaik, Allahumma labbaik, ya Allah, ya I am. That is the words that you say, that is the words that you cry for. Allah has given you the rahmah, Allah has given you his rahmah, to come to Saudi Arabia to make your Hajj. It is an invitation from the Almighty. It is not just a journey that you prepared. It is an invitation. Allah has given you the privilege. The Saudis has given you the visa. But it is through Allah's rahmah and Allah's khaniyat that you are there for Hajj. Inshallah, may all of you come. And who haven't been on Hajj, may Allah give you the experience. To go there and experience the opportunity of redemption. When you stand on Arafah and you ask Allah, ya Allah, astaghfirullah. We were studying and making dua. And the Imam said, brothers, if you cannot make dua in Arabic, leave the Arabic because you don't understand it. The emotion of the dua can be said in any language, English, Afrikaans, any language. Say it in the language you want to say it in, not the language that you think you know and you don't know. So all of you, inshallah, if you haven't been, please, it is a journey worth taking. It cleanses you spiritually, physically, emotionally. And it helps you in your life. My father always said, if you go for Hajj, you will never become destitute. Allah will always look after you because you have taken the time to go to the biggest mosque in the world, the Haram. So inshallah, take the opportunity. I am emotional. I work in Riyadh. I have the opportunity to go for Umrah every now and again. I go to Medina and Makkah every now and again. And I feel very, very, very humble in front of you today that I've had the experience and I have the opportunities over and over and over to do that. Inshallah, may Allah reward you with that experience. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum.
All right, we've got just two, three very quick items and then we're going to end up. So we will end well before Maghrib. Just by the way, there's also facilities for Asr Salah upstairs. I believe it is, right? Yeah? Okay. That you can do even now. I'm going to call upon now Catherine Constantinides, who is amongst the most inspirational young South Africans I have met ever. I think Yusuf would say the same thing. She's a social activist, a change agent, but also very relevant to all of us. She's currently spending lots of time with the Sahrawi people, which you may know is one of the last colonies of the African continent, annexed by Morocco. But for now, and she just come back from a refugee camp with the Sahrawi people. But for now, your big job, Catherine, is to introduce the Minister of Tourism, Minister Derek Hanekom. Thank you.
Good afternoon. It's really an honor and a privilege to be here among such distinguished guests this afternoon. Before I start to introduce Minister Hanekom, who is most certainly my favorite minister in South Africa, I have to say that the spirit of Hajj is something that lives within every person. Despite religion and beliefs, this is a spiritual journey, and I think that today has allowed us to really reflect on our own spirituality and to really reflect on our own journeys as human beings. And I think that it has been said so many times this afternoon that Yusuf has allowed us an insight into something very special and something that is not just a normal Hajj. And Kevin rightly put it, it's a Hajj that Yusuf went on. And he took us all with him on that very special journey. This afternoon, I have the privilege of introducing to you somebody who has lived, learned, and left a legacy for us. He is the current Minister of Tourism in South Africa. He's also the chairman of the Kathrada Foundation. He was former Minister of Agriculture and Land Affairs under the Nelson Mandela presidency, and he was the former Minister of Science and Technology.
I recently was in the US for a fellowship program. And while I was in the US, I was asked to go down to Virginia Tech in Virginia. And while I was there, I had the privilege of meeting somebody who had to speak to me about a great South African that he once knew. And as he spoke about this great South African man and told me many stories about him, this man happened to be our very own Minister Derek Hanekom. And I was very, very excited to share with this man on the other side of the world that I in fact knew this minister and held him in very high regard. He is most certainly a man who does not do what is easy, but does what is right. And in a time in South Africa when we find ourselves flustered with dark clouds that we have to get through, this is a minister who is really leading the way. He's a minister with integrity, one that you can trust, and one that will leave a legacy in South Africa for many of us to follow. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together as we introduce Minister Derek Hanekom.
How terribly embarrassing. No. Ismail Vadi over there, the MEC, if he's still here, who is my comrade and fellow member of the Kathrada Foundation, will tell you that I am just ordinary old Derek. Nothing special about me, but thank you very much, Catherine, for those words. Ashraf, thank you for all of the stuff that you've been doing over here. Consul General and the Acting Ambassador. The two editors of The Star and The Mail and Guardian, Khadija and Kevin. Can we just congratulate Khadija, young South African woman. Really, stand up, take it. You really do us proud. What we know from Khadija is that she will pursue journalistic excellence with integrity, and that's what we need in South Africa, and fearlessly. And that's what we need. Thank you, Khadija. Kevin, you agree with all of that?
Absolutely.
Thank you. Now, Mzwaki. I mean, really, you take me right back to those UDF days when he was a towering giant. He spoke and he got us all excited and he got us all enthusiastic and passionate. Many of you will remember that. Do you remember him from the UDF days? The older amongst you do. But one thing that he's not lost it. He hasn't lost it. It's difficult to speak after Mzwaki because if you unpack everything that he said, it was so loaded with many, many messages that there isn't really very much to add. Thank you, Mzwaki, also for being this icon and an inspirer of so many people. So, dear friends, dear ladies and gentlemen, I know a lot of you are going off, and so I am at the huge disadvantage of speaking to you as you are looking at your watches and as everyone has said everything that needs to be said. But peace and everything beautiful upon you all. And thank you so much for inviting me. You probably know, but you mustn't make that assumption that I'm not Muslim. You probably know that. That's an advantage. Because I can get it all wrong when I speak about the Hajj and I speak about the pilgrimage, and you'll say, oh, don't worry. You know, he'll learn. He's not really Muslim. But the other thing about being invited as not Muslim, it says something about the Muslim community. And that is, it is a Muslim community that is fully integrated with our South African society. It's not a Bantustan Muslim community. So what we have here, I mean, a very, very, I have done so many book launches and I love doing book launches because I love books. But this is a book launch with a difference. I've never been to a book launch with such a long lineup of speakers for that matter. But it's also, it's launching a book that is different. And the book is about an experience that is different. An experience that you do, that many people have done, many South Africans, that makes you no longer the same person once you've done it, but different, better. And through the effect of the pilgrimage and the return from the pilgrimage, it's not just doing the Hajj because it's compulsory. We know it's compulsory. People will do it if they're able to do it, but people do it because they want to do it. And people do it and they come back better and they come back enriched. and that is the value of the Hajj. And what they do is they ensure that the effect of the pilgrimage goes way beyond the 1.8 million people who attend it annually. 1.8 something. Now 1.8 million people that did the Hajj this year is like a tiny percentage of all of the Muslims in the world. I think there are about 1.7 billion Muslims in the world. We in South Africa, we have our share. We have about 750,000 Muslims living in South Africa, proudly integrated in our South African community. So the Hajj makes a difference. But anyway, I'm the Minister of Tourism, I'm not the Minister of the Hajj. And so I've got to tell you, you know, we live in a beautiful country. And it's October. And, you know, there's a poem. I'm sure you, the poet, the people's poet, knows about other poetry as well, not only your own poetry. You remember that poem that says, "October is the moister, moister month." October is a beautiful month. And we see the jacarandas out there in full bloom. And it's beautiful. We see it. But tourism is not just about seeing things. There are blind people in South Africa who cannot see, but they experience things. Tourism is about experiencing things. It's about the smells and the taste and the connectedness with people. It's about the profound experiences, the memorable experiences that change you in some little way. And so tourism, including the Hajj, which is a tourism activity, even if you call it religious tourism, even if you call it a pilgrimage, it is about getting out of your neighborhood, getting out of your comfort zone, discovering new things, interacting with people, making a difference, becoming different, and making that choice. And that is tourism. So the Hajj, now, I haven't done it. I was in Saudi Arabia recently, and I thought, I'm here. Why can't I do the Hajj? And I was told I cannot. I have to do certain things in order to be able to do it. And I've got in my ministry, I've got Sharif who's sitting over here. He's a Muslim, so he keeps, you know, educating me about Islam. And I learn about it. And then I've got the chief of staff in my ministry is also a Muslim. So, you know, I don't want you to make this headlines in the newspaper, please, man. But it does seem like a little bit of Muslim capture in the ministry, you know. But it's good capture. This one is good capture. The Hajj and what I know of it. And so many of you even seated here today, you know so much of it, but you've not done it. And you dream of doing it. But from everybody, every Muslim that I know, even those that are, now I don't know who to look at right now, as I say it, even those Muslims that I know are not that religious, you know, don't necessarily do all the things that they're meant to do. You know who I'm talking about, yeah? Not your immediate neighbor, but somewhere behind you. Even the Muslims that don't do everything that a Muslim is meant to do, they still dream of doing the Hajj. I do not know a single Muslim in South Africa who does not want to do the Hajj one day. I don't know of a single Muslim in South Africa who has done the Hajj for whom it has not been a profound experience and a life-changing experience. And that's what the Hajj is. So people in South Africa, yes, compulsory, but people want to do it. People dream of it. So thank you, Yusuf, because this is not about me, it's about you. Thank you for sharing, because so much we've heard. You know, you speak to Sharif and he says, you know, Sharif, have you done the Hajj? Yeah, what was it like? It was fantastic. You know, thank you. And then he starts talking about, or we start talking about, you know, fees must fall, or about, all the latest episodes that I don't want to go into now. But here you've captured it. You've captured the heart and the soul and the spirit and the meaning of the Hajj. And this is the first time I am seeing it. 400 pictures in that book. 400 pictures taken with an iPhone. I can't believe it. I've looked at every one of those 400 pictures. Some of them are just beautiful. Some of them tell a story, a really rich story. So thank you, Yusuf, for sharing it with the people of South Africa. But thank you also, Yusuf, for being such an exemplary and inspiring citizen yourself. Thank you for what you have done to South Africa. There he is. He doesn't always wear it, but he's wearing his Muslim attire. But you can see underneath it, he's got jeans and all sorts of things. But Muslim attire with a difference. You see, Mzwaki, you see that patriotism. That is this fellow. A patriotic South African, an inspiring South African, a South African that has made his mark. It's not for nothing that he got the Order of Baobab awarded on him. Let's give him a big round of applause. So at the end of the day, you know better than I do that the Hajj is just a pilgrimage. It's one of many, many pilgrimages. It probably is the biggest pilgrimage in the world, but it's a pilgrimage, a journey to a holy place, a journey to a sacred place. That's what it is. The ambassador of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, in his foreword to the book, says this: pilgrims explore their spiritual heritage, reflecting on their own spiritual development. So it's not only doing because you have to do it, it's about spiritual development. And it is that that I also want to highlight, and which comes out in the book. It's not only about going there and having the spiritual experience and going through the spiritual development, but it's taking South Africa to Makkah. It's taking Ubuntu, the spirit of Ubuntu, to Makkah. And that is wonderful. It's also experiencing Ubuntu from other people. Ubuntu is not unique to us in South Africa. It is not unique to us, but we pride ourselves on that, and we must cling to it, and we must sell it. And we go there to Makkah, and we don't just go there for our own spiritual enrichment. We go there to share it with other people. And that's what you've done. I think I was really touched by the fact that there are poor people in Makkah, very, very poor people who have taken their lifelong savings to get there and hardly have enough money left over to buy food. And the fact that you've helped people there, just taking that spirit of Ubuntu to Makkah, I think is the most inspiring thing imaginable. You come back from Makkah, you come back from the Hajj a better person. You come back changed, and you come back to be a changer. You come back to be a contributor to the betterment of humanity, the carrier of higher values, and that is the real value. But we have our own pilgrimage. I don't want to speak for too long, but we've got to also value our own pilgrimages in South Africa, because no matter how many people go to the Hajj, no matter how many people of different religions who do different pilgrimages, we love our religious diversity and cultural diversity in South Africa. I can't conceive of a country without a Muslim population. Inconceivable in South Africa. But at the end of the day, we have our own stories to tell in South Africa. We have our own pilgrimage. So all of the wonderful cultural and all forms of diversity must be celebrated. Each person is unique, and we believe that each person should have the freedom to express their uniqueness in their own way. But while we are all different, we are just so much the same. Let's not forget that. Let's not forget the biggest and most important thing, and that is our common humanity. You don't have, when you're born, when you're a young child, you don't have a religion. You don't have a race. You don't think of yourself as white or black or anything else. You are just a child, a vulnerable child, innocent child, and you have the same emotions as all other children, same pain, same anguish, same suffering as all other children all over the world. And when you reach adulthood, you have the same joys. You have the same love, and you have the same emotion. And we feel pain, and we feel sadness, and we feel it together in our common humanity, and South Africa tells the story of our common humanity. So even if we go right back before the Holy Prophet Muhammad, when we go back to Ibrahim, we go back to Jesus, they all come from the African continent. Their ancestry is from this African continent of ours. Everyone, from the indigenous forests in the Amazon to the Aboriginal people in Australia, everyone comes from the African continent initially, and we have it. We have it right here, an hour away from us. A World Heritage Site that tells the story about our common roots, our common humanity, our common origins, and we must celebrate it and sell it to the world, and that should be a pilgrimage as well. And we have another pilgrimage, Robben Island. Didn't you spend some time in Robben Island? No, she spent a lot of time in detention, that much I can tell you. A lot of time being harassed, that much I can tell you. But not on Robben Island. But Robben Island is another World Heritage Site that tells a story that we should share with the world. And it tells a different kind of story, like 2 million years later, from the discovery of the Homo naledis and other early ancestors of ours. It tells the story of the human spirit, of resilience, of forgiveness, that you capture so well in your poetry, Mizwaki. That is the story that we need to tell the world. That should be part of the pilgrimage. The world, let's say, landscape of pilgrimages. And if you go to Robben Island, there's something less known about Robben Island. I bet not every one of you, I know a lot of you haven't done the Hajj, but much closer to home is the cradle of humankind. Much closer to home is Robben Island. Many of you haven't been there. If you go to Robben Island, you'll find what? Nelson Mandela's cell, yes. You'll find a karamat there. You'll find a story of early Islamic resistance to what is evil, to injustice, to slavery, and there's the story that Robben Island also tells. But anyway, back to Hajj. We're not talking about Robben Island. And Yusuf's book, and photography, because it's all about photography. And photography is a form of art, and it captures that, you, with a camera. You're capturing a little moment in history. You're capturing a moment in time. And good photography, of course, is artwork. But every photography, even with your little iPhone, and even you, Catherine, with your Samsung, because I know you have a Samsung, not an iPhone, you're capturing moments every minute of the day. These 2 hours that we've been here, there have been literally hundreds and hundreds of pictures taken. And pictures that capture the moment. Pictures that you share with your friends. And so what you've got here is a collection of 400 pictures that capture the magic moments, that capture the experience, and is then shared with many people so that that experience can be appreciated. And what I like most is that this book that you so successfully auctioned over here, that the 2,000 people that currently, South Africans that currently do the Hajj, there are hundreds of thousands of other Muslims in South Africa that would love to do the Hajj, some of who can't because of the limitations in numbers of people, and some of whom can't because they cannot afford it. They can't even dream of doing the Hajj. And the fact that you're using this opportunity to help people fulfill their dreams, I say thank you to you. And I'm sure the whole Muslim community and South African community says thank you to you, because as I've said, the Hajj is not just about Muslims. The Hajj is about values. The Hajj is about what you come back with. And so let me just say, your last page in the book, it says something I think profound, and it's quoting somebody who should be fairly well known to you, fairly well called the Holy Prophet Muhammad. Should be very well known to you. And this is what the Holy Prophet Muhammad says in your book. Do you know what is better than charity or fasting? It is keeping good relationships between people, as quarrels and bad feelings destroy mankind. And that is what the Prophet Muhammad said. And that is a message that is so important for us, because our quarrels and the wrongs that are present amongst us are destroying us. So dear friends, dear Yusuf, all of you, let's stand up. Let's stand together with the noblest of Islamic values. Let's stand together with the noblest of Christian values. Let's stand together with the noblest of all kinds of values and the spirit of Ubuntu. And let's do with integrity what we need to do to fight the wrongs that are around us. Because we are a great country of great people. There is so much more good than there is evil. Let us build the good. Let us be the change, be the good, and fight the evil. And let the best of us prevail. Let's choose. We chose to be here. Now it's up to us to choose to do the right things and choose, to quote Ashram, to choose to make our country the greatest nation on earth. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for that. I could say, you know, as Minister Hanekom said, we can't assume what's his faith. So I can say, and you need to hear this, as you said, Derek. Thank you, Imam Hanekom. Thank you, Sheikh Hanekom. Thank you, Maulana Hanekom. Most appreciated. And I think the bottom line to all he said, Muslims in South Africa, we maka plan. But the word maka is an important point around that. All right, let's get to Yasin Teba now to just give the vote of thanks, then we'll have a final dua thereafter. Everybody knows him as the Mr. Operation Hydrate Man. 50, 60 million rands collected for this country in a matter of time. It's unparalleled. I'd like to think your next project has got to be something to do with education. You know how important that is, okay? There we are.
Minister, dignitaries,
I've been warned by the caterer, and I'm told that it's okay to say all protocol observed once the caterer warns you. I want to start firstly by thanking Yusuf Abramjee for giving me the opportunity to always work by his side. It's always a pleasure, a learning experience. He motivates and inspires us to always do good. And I want to firstly thank Yusuf for giving me that opportunity. I want to thank him for his confidence in vision branding to get this book published. I want to start off very, very quickly with firstly honoring Yusuf's parents, if they can come up very quickly. Or maybe is Papa gone to, okay. Yusuf, Ibrahim Abramjee and Maryam Abramjee, better known as Papa and Big Mommy. Yusuf wants to honor them with a copy of the book. Can you please come forward, Big Mommy, Papa? Minister, if you can join us on the stage, please. Ladies and gentlemen, this book has by far broken many, many records. We were just so busy getting the book published and edited that we didn't have sufficient time to start our stopwatches. But I assure you, we broke lots of records. I'd like to call up Mohammed Ismail. Mohammed Ismail, where are you? Is it you? Mohammed Ismail, Khatija, Hussein, Bashir. An amazing team. I doubt it will be our first book we'll do. Just give out that stuff, right? Uncle Farooq, please join us. Special thanks to the iStore. Once they heard that Yusuf took all the photos with his iPhone, they sponsored a lot of equipment. Some of the gifts that we're giving away today is from the iStore. We'd like to thank Mama Joy for joining us. Thank you, Mama. Thank you for always supporting us. You make us proudly South Africa. To the Houghton Golf Club, is there anyone from the Houghton Golf Club still in the hall, or are they all upstairs? Robbie and team, thank you for sponsoring this venue. We really appreciate it and appreciate your support. To Tonka Bean Bakeries, thank you for your big sponsorship. All the confectioneries are from Tonka Bean. Judging from the amount of times I run to the kitchen, Minister, if we can get Tonka Bean at passport control, I'm sure we'll up tourism. Is Nasima from Tonka Bean, are you here? Please come forward, Nasima. Those of you that haven't tasted Tonka Bean, you must out. It's upstairs. It's absolutely amazing. But thank you for your sponsorship, Nasima. Please pass on our regards to Shaquille as well. Thank you to Teba Function Hire for sponsoring all the furniture upstairs as well. Suk Islam Ahmed, thank you for your support. Zain Bika and his team, I think Zain's left already, but Zain Bika and the team, the sound engineer, drama, thank you. We really appreciate it. Thanks for coming out. Ubuntu Islam, thank you for your support. Tahir and Uzair, thank you guys. Thank you for coming. You guys are amazing. Keep it up. Our MC, who's been absolutely fantastic, Ashraf Garda, thank you for always supporting us. Thank you for always making everything possible. We really appreciate your support, your retweets, and your mentions on radio. Uncle Ismail Vadi, if you can join us. In front. Sheikh Daud Samson, if you can please join us in front.
We're giving this one to MSC Badi, my dear friend. He never wears a shirt and trouser, he wears a kurta. And I'm happy, thanks to my sister in law, Rizia, we're now branding this kurta. Mr. Hanekom is going to get one because he's got a South African colors, and MSC Badi will hopefully get one as well.
We'll give it out. Acting Ambassador, if you can join us, please.
Sekasu, if you can also join us, please.
The Muhammad Abaskan is one of the right? And Shoaib Kasu is one of the points in the community. Right? Okay? Okay. You don't have to declare it. Shoaib Kasu. I know you can't take
baggage to those of you that know Yusuf Abramjee will know that he's always on his phone, always tweeting. He always wants to get that second picture in. I often wonder how Firoza, his wife, manages hanging around him. But I think we need to honor Firoza. Auntie Firoza, are you around?
Can I just say something? Give the somebody asked me the question. How did your wife manage on this Hajj trip? I said, ask her. But really, I think to them and to Fahim and Zahir, my two sons who are helping them, Mr. Minister, these are the people together with my family, my brothers, my nephews, my nieces, all of them. Please come forward. Please come forward. No, don't do it in a quiet way. Let Minister Anakom give it there. Thank you very much to the family and to Fahim and Zahir. Yasin will do the other one.
A lot of people say that I'm so inspired by Yusuf that I also married a Firoza. Firoza Teba. Okay, we'll send Firoza to the back, right, guys? Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us. We really appreciate your support. Catherine.
Who else, guys? Who else have we got? Is it all done? Oh, it's fine. It's fine. Okay, that's fine. It's Firoza's. It's my wife, Firoza.
Mona Chunara, thank you for your final dua. We just got a little gift for you. Ladies and gentlemen, refreshments are being served on the deck. If you just go out of the hall, up the stairs, there's musallas there for men to perform salah.
To come, just one second. Yeah. Right, are you done, Yasin? All right, let's then we're going to wrap up. We'll have the nasheeds from Tariq and Uzair just now, but the final dua for today coming from Maulana Israel Chunara from the West Street Mosque in Houghton, a man who's inspired many of us when we frequent that masjid.
آمين. والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم فصل وسلم وزد وأنعم وبارك على سيد المرسلين إمامنا محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Oh Allah, most kind, gracious, beloved, almighty Allah, bless us in everything that we do, Allah. Allah, open for us with goodness, let our life be one that is filled with goodness, and let us have an end that is one that is a representation of goodness. Oh Allah, Ghafoor, oh Rahim, for every pilgrimage there certainly is a reward. We ask you to reward all those individuals who've taken on the pilgrimage of life, Allah. O Allah, Ghafoor, O Rahim, we ask you through their sacrifices to place blessings on this land, Allah. For giving and dedicating themselves to you, Allah, we ask you to bless our land, the people of this land, to make it once again a place of safety and security and peace and aman and barakah, a place that is filled with blessings, Allah. Allah, as you had united the people on the plains of Arafah, and you had united the people in Mina, and you had united them in the tawaf and in the various rituals of Hajj, we ask you to unite the forces and the people in this country, Allah. We ask you to give us unity and understanding and peace and solidarity and the ability to coincide and the ability to live peacefully and happy with each other. O Allah, those who are involved in the publishing of this book, in making this journey a reality, in opening the eyes of millions of people to what the wonderful journey of Hajj is, we ask you to reward them abundantly, Allah. Those who have gone for Hajj, reward them and accept their Hajj. Those who wish to go for Hajj, Allah, take them soon, Allah. O Allah, O Ghafoor, O Rahim, we ask you to take us over and over to the holy lands. We ask you to bless us in our sleeping, in our walking, in our talking, in our laughing, in our interacting with each other, and in everything that we do. Protect us in our country always. Keep it wonderful as it is, Allah, and grant us the ability to sleep smiling, to wake up smiling, and to live smiling. Allahumma salli wa sallim da'iman abada ala habibika khairil khalqi kullihimi subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun ala al mursaleen walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
Okay, as we come to the end of the program, just a couple of things to note. For those that wish to perform the Maghrib Salah, the Maghrib prayers, you can do that upstairs. But those that are not doing that also can have refreshments upstairs as well. And if there's one final word I will leave you with, of all the things Yusuf has said, the most common phrase is used when describing other people has been my dear friend. You use it very often. When you use that often, you ingrain that into your life. So he's embraced that as an attitude, my dear friend. It's something I think we should all take heed of. For all of us, as per the instruction in the beginning, go and tell everybody else about it. And I'll leave you with this. In terms of the original point about the Hajj, so it was no ordinary Hajj, because quite honestly, Yusuf Abramjee is genuinely no ordinary man as well. Get the book, hashtag Abramjee on Hajj as well, to tell everybody else. And I hope you had a very, very splendid afternoon, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I've said.